also the before the colonic carcinoma, the age incidence is almost equal, male female. Okay. What are the risk factors? What causes colonic carcinoma? Again, most of the time it is sporadic. Then we have genetic factors. Then we have environmental factors. Okay. Genetic factors, again, as in the rectal carcinoma, familial adenomatous polyposis coli is a very important factor. As I told you, in FAP, it is an autosomal dominant condition. It occurs because of mutation in the ABC gene, which occurs on the short arm of chromosome 5. In this very young age, they develop polyps. About 100 of polyps is there. Minimum 100 polyps should be there for diagnosis of FAP. The whole colon is palpated with polyps. And by the time they are 40 years of age, all of them will develop colonic carcinoma. Okay. FAP has polyps not only in large intestine, but also in the small intestine, duodenum also. Okay. And FAP is associated with other syndromes also, where if it is associated with desmoid tumor and epidermoid tumor, then we call it Gardner syndrome. If it is associated with CNS tumors, we call it Turgot syndrome, and so on and so forth. So FAP is a dangerous condition. So how do we treat FAP? You have to put patient in surveillance by the time they reach puberty, and since one of the colon is usually involved, so the treatment will be either you do a total proctocolectomy with an end ileostomy. Okay, you have removed all the colon down to the anal canal. So the patient is put on the permanent end ileostomy. Or if he doesn't want ileostomy, but the other thing you can do is restorative proctocolectomy, in which you remove the whole colon and you remove the rectum, and then you make a pouch and do an ileal pouch and an anastomosis. From the ileal, you make a pouch, J shaped, W shaped, and attach it to the anal canal. This is called restorative proctocolectomy with ileal anal pouch anastomosis. Okay, so these two things you can do for the treatment of FAP. Then another condition which increases risk of colonic cancer is HNPCC, hereditary non-polyposis colorectal carcinoma. And this usually occurs because of the mutation in the DNA repair genes. There is microsatellite instability. Here, colonic carcinoma occurs in people younger than 50 years of age. There is Amsterdam criteria for diagnosing it. The three successive generations are involved. Okay. At least three members of the family are involved, and at least two successive generations, and one of them should be the first degree relative. If any of these criteria is there, we call it, then it goes in favor of HNPCC. In HNPCC, the colorectal carcinoma, the increased risk of colorectal carcinoma is there, as well as there is increased risk of other malignancy, as in a stomach malignancy, a pancreatic malignancy, ovarian and endometrial malignancy. All these malignancy has increased risk in HNPCC. So you have to put these patients on surveillance. Okay. And also mutation in P53 gene and KRAS genes, they all increase the risk of colonic carcinoma. Then there are dietary factors. What are the dietary factors which can increase the risk of colonic carcinoma? It has been seen that those who take a lot of red meat, saturated animal fat, less fiber, or more alcohol, smoking, they are all associated with increased risk of colonic carcinoma. Some operations like cholecystectomy increases the weight of colonic carcinoma, especially on the right side, marginally. Okay, so these are the risk factors for colon carcinoma. How will patient present to you with who has got colonic carcinoma? See, usually if a lesion on the right side, they usually present with bleeding, melena, iron deficiency anemia, weakness. Left sided lesion can present with hematoplasia or rectal bleeding, pain in the abdomen, change in bowel habit. Patient can have either diarrhea or constipation. Okay, pain abdomen. Okay, right-sided lesions, the usual pain is in the periambilical region. Left-sided lesion pain is based more on the supraambilical region. Okay. So patient can have either change in bowel habit, patient can have weakness because of anemia, iron deficiency anemia, patient can have constipation, patient can have, can present to you with obstruction, intestinal obstruction and all. Okay. Colonic carcinoma, you know, this will be more than 95% of the time it will be adenocarcinoma. And macroscopically, we describe it into four types. It can be an ulcerative lesion, it can be annular lesion, it can be tubular lesion, or it can be a polypoidal, polyflower-like lesion. Okay, polypoidal, polyflower-like lesion. And how do you stage colonic carcinoma? Again, you have Duke's staging and TNM staging. In Duke's staging, Duke A, B, C, later on we have added D. A is limited to rectal valve, that is, they are not, they up to the muscularis propria. Okay? They are not bridged muscularis propria, they are up to the propria. Muscularis propria is A. B is, they are bridged muscularis propria, but no lymph node involvement. See anywhere in the rectal wall with lymph node involvement. D later on is added, distal metastasis. Okay. TNM staging is also there. As I told, TX can't be assessed, T0 no evidence, TIS in situ, then T1 is up to submucosa. Mucosa, lesions start from mucosa, so lesion has gone up to submucosa, we call it T1. T2 it has gone up to muscular layer, muscularis propria. T3 has gone up to subserosa. T4 it has gone beyond and called adjacent structures. Okay. N1, 1 to 3 nodes involved. N2, 4 or more nodes involved. Okay. M0 nomads, M1 metastasis. Okay. And so how do we diagnose, what investigation we do? Obviously we will do a colonoscopy in these patients to see where is the lesion. We take multiple biopsy from the lesion. Okay. For staging, you can do CECT of abdomen, you can do CECT thorax, you can do PET CT, where fluorodeoxyglucose glucose uptake by the tumor cells is seen, which will show you that this is a malignant tumor or this is a metastasis is there. So you have to do colonoscopy first, take multiple biopsy, and do CECT abdomen and chest, and then do PET CT. And of course, you will do all the blood tests, CBC, LFT, renal function test and all. And important marker is there, which is CEA level, carcinoembryonic antigen level. CEA, carcinoembryonic antigen, is produced by the colonic mucosa itself. And the normal level is usually less than 5 nanogram per ml. If it is very high, it suggests poor prognosis. Okay? If the, even after operation, the level is high, it means the disease, persistent disease is there. Okay. Or if after operation CEA level comes down to normal and then after 6 months or so it rises again, then you know it is a recurrent tumor, recurrence of the tumor has occurred. Okay. So this is how you investigate. Next class we will discuss about the treatment strategies of carcinoma.